Hey, space friends, this week I'm geeking out about moon rings. Not mood rings, but moon rings. The interaction between planetary rings and moons, specifically at Saturn. A while back, I did a video about some of my favorite weird moons. One of those weird moons that I documented was Pan, the ravioli moon. Pan is a moon in one of Saturn's rings that accumulates sort of a tutu around it as it goes through the rings. So as Pan is flying around Saturn and picking up stuff in its ring, it creates this sort of ravioli-like shape as a result. There's another tiny moon at Saturn that has a different interaction with Saturn's rings. It's called Daphnis. And Daphnis creates these beautiful waves in its wake as it goes around Saturn. So it uses its tiny amount of gravity for this very tiny moon and is able to create these beautiful wave patterns in Saturn's rings. But today I wanted to geek out with you specifically about what Enceladus does with Saturn's rings. A while back, I also made a video about Enceladus and all the stuff I love about it and why it's so just such a wonderful moon in our solar system. It's one of my all-time favorites. But while I talked about a bunch of really cool things about Enceladus that you should definitely go check out, I left out one really awesome fact. The outermost visible ring of Saturn? Enceladus built that. Yeah, built it using its famous plumes from its south pole. It actually spews out tons and tons of stuff, and that tons of stuff creates Saturn's outermost visible ring. Enceladus actually created it. What Enceladus is building around Saturn is actually more akin to a donut than a ring. While a lot of Saturn's rings are really thin, this is more like a donut of water vapor around Saturn. And this is because Enceladus is just spewing out so much stuff from its plumes. It's estimated that it's actually spewing out 250 kilograms of water vapor every second at supersonic speeds. Just thinking about that is a lot, and you can imagine how Enceladus is able to actually then build an entire donut ring around the entire planet of Saturn. 3 to 5% of that water actually ends up back on Saturn itself. So Saturn has a little bit of water on it, thanks to the splashovers happening from Enceladus. Back in the 1980s, when Voyager 2 flew by Saturn, people suspected that maybe Enceladus was the creator of this outermost ring. But people weren't really certain. They saw that Enceladus, this tiny, tiny little moon, was in the center of this ring, but they thought, how could a tiny moon, so tiny, create this huge ring around Saturn? People weren't really sure, and so some people actually discounted this theory. It wasn't until Cassini actually then flew by Enceladus in 2005, and the Cassini imaging team was able to get actual images and photographic proof of Enceladus caught in the act creating this ring, that it was then proven that Enceladus does create this ring of Saturn. This all really highlights the importance of using imaging and cameras in science to actually make scientific discoveries. All too often, and still in some scientific groups, people discount imaging as something that is just for PR or fun and not actually useful in aiding for scientific discoveries or making scientific discoveries themselves. This shows that imaging can make scientific discoveries and really be helpful for confirming discoveries that people suspect but aren't yet sure about. Imaging is so important for science, and I can only hope that in the future, more and more people know the importance of putting cameras on spacecrafts and other instruments as they explore our world and the universe. Okay, that's it for me this week. I hope you enjoyed. As always, in the YouTube description, I will be putting links that are relevant to this topic. Also, check out the really awesome patrons that are helping support videos like this one. If you want to become a really awesome patron yourself and help support videos like this, I really appreciate it, and you can head on over to my Patreon campaign and check that out. I'll see you all next week, and remember to always be exploring.